Hi friends, now in this session we are going to do some problems about the cross flow and multi-flow heat exchanger. This is the problem number 1 in this section. Okay, here I am taking the problem from the Sachideva. Here in this example 12.7 we can able to see the saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius is condensing on a shell solid of a shell and tube heat exchanger. Okay, the cooling water enters the tube at 30 degrees Celsius and leaves at 70 degrees Celsius. Here your question is to find out the effective logarithm mean temperature difference if the arrangement is, for the three arrangements they are asking the LMTD, counterflow, if the arrangement is counterflow, or if the arrangement is a parallel flow, and if the arrangement is a cross flow. Okay, now as per the question, first we need to draw the diagram for the counter flow. Okay, first counter flow heat exchanger. As we know, the counter flow heat exchanger, both the fluids are passing in the opposite direction. Okay, actually here it is given as a saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Steam at 100 degrees Celsius is condensing on a shell side of a tube. Shell side of a tube means, suppose this is a shell and tube heat exchanger. Just consider this as a shell and tube heat exchanger. The inlet of the shell side is 100 degree steam. And the output should be the 100 degree water. Here the temperature of the both inlet and outlet is same. Okay, this is a condensing type heat exchanger. For cooling process, for absorbing the heat from the hot fluid to cold fluid, for the cooling purpose we are using the water, which is enters at 30 degrees Celsius and leaves at 70 degrees Celsius. Okay, but here the counterflow heat exchanger, this is a simply counterflow heat exchanger means like so. Here water is flowing on, here the steam is flowing on. Here steam, here water. Okay, now drawing the graph, you can able to see the steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Steam, okay, 100 degree steam is condensing to 100 degree water. The temperature drops, no temperature drop is here. Okay, hence it is a straight line. This is 100 degree water. At the same time, here the water enters at a 30 degrees Celsius and leaves at 70 degrees Celsius by absorbing heat from this steam. The cooling fluid is like so. Cooling curve is like so. This is 30 degree water and 70 degree water. Here the phase change happens. Okay, all the heat losing from this 100 degree steam is 100 degree steam is changes to 100 degree water. That means here the phase change occurs from the vapor to liquid. Okay, here the latent heat is removing with the help of this cooling water, and the direction is like so because it is a counterflow heat exchanger. As we know, this is a delta T1 and this is a delta T2. With the help of the HMT data book, we can able to find out the LMTD for counterflow heat exchanger. Its answer will be more or less equal to 47.2 degrees Celsius. Please do it. Please do it. Okay. Now, similarly, please try it for the parallel flow heat exchanger. For parallel flow heat exchanger, the graph will be somewhat like similar to this one. Here also 100 degree, the direction is same. This is 100 degree steam, 100 degree water. Okay, now the curve is, the direction is same. This is inlet temperature of the water. Sorry, this graph is wrong. This which is 30 degree water and 70 degree output. Now this is the delta T1 and this is delta T2. Okay. Now please do it, the LMTD for parallel flow heat exchanger. The answer will be more or less will be equal to the 47.2 itself, 47.2 degrees itself. Okay. Now our problem is to find out for what is the LMTD for delta T, LMTD for cross flow heat exchanger. As we know, for the cross flow or multi-pass heat exchanger, we need to concern about the factor F, correction factor F into delta T LM for counter flow heat exchanger. It is very important. Correction factor F into LMTD of counter flow heat exchanger. It is the delta T, that means logarithmic mean temperature difference for the cross flow or multi-pass heat exchanger. For that, now we know that what is LMTD for counter flow heat exchanger. From the previous case, we know that it is 47.2 degree. But now our task is to find out what is the F value. Okay, the F value we can able to see it from the we can able to get from the curve, which is available in the page number 159. It is a simple one shell and a one shell and two pass heat exchanger, two pass heat exchanger. Here from this value we can see what is the value of R and what is the value of P. Okay, here R value is equal to, you can able to see R is the capital T1 minus capital T2. Capital T1 minus capital T2 means the inlet side of the shell and outlet side of the shell. Here you can see inlet side of the shell is 100 degrees Celsius and outlet side of the shell is also 100 degrees Celsius divided by small T2 minus small T1. That means outlet side of the tube minus inlet side of the tube. Here outlet side of the tube is 70 minus 30. 70 minus 30. It is 40. 0 by 40. Answer is 0. Here also, then now we are going to find out the P, value of P. P is equal to small T2 minus small T1. That means outlet minus inlet. 70 minus 30, 40 divided by capital T1 minus small T1. Capital T1 means 100 degrees Celsius. 100 degrees Celsius minus small T1 means 30 degrees Celsius. That means 40 divided by 6, 70. That means 4 by 7. That value will be 4 by 7. Here the value of the R is 0. Hence, it is a special case of the heat exchanger. As in the question says, it is a condenser type heat exchanger. In the question itself, it is mentioning that it is a condenser on the shell side of the shell and tube heat exchanger. Actually, this is a condenser type heat exchanger. As I said in the last lecture, for the evaporator as well as for the condenser heat exchanger, the value of F should be equal to 1. Okay, hence we can directly say it as delta T LM for cross flow heat exchanger will be equal to F into delta T LM for counter flow. Now the value of F equal to 1. 1 into delta T of counter flow. Hence the answer will be equal to 47.2 degrees Celsius. This is the same case for the evaporator too. Now, what is the good value for F? Factor of safety. It is a general case. Okay. The F value should be, if it is during calculation, if it is greater than 0.75, then the heat exchanger is very good in design. If it is less than 0.75, it is poor in design. Okay, this is another criteria while during the design for the multi-flow or cross-flow heat exchanger. Now we are going for the second problem. Okay, in this text also it is given in 12.8. Now we are going to see, in a food processing power plant, water is to be cooled from 18 degrees Celsius to 6.5 degrees Celsius. by using the brine solution entering at the inlet temperature of -1.1 degree and leaving at 2.9 degrees Celsius. Here the coolant is the brine and your heated medium is the water. Okay, hot fluid is water. Here the question is, what area is required when a shell and tube heat exchanger with water making one shell pass and brine making two tube passes? That means actually this is a question from single shell to tube passes heat exchanger. Okay, assume an overall average heat transfer coefficient as 850 watt per meter square and design of the heat exchanger load is 6000 watt. That means the Q is 6000 watt and here the U is 850 watt per meter square. Suppose if it is not given in the question, we need to take it from our heat transfer data book. Okay, in page number 156, they are giving the overall heat exchanger between the two fluids. Here, all the parameters are just writing down, the given data are writing down. In the shell side, T inlet is 18 degrees Celsius and T outlet is 6.5. Okay, in the tube side, it is given as it is minus, the inlet is -1.1 degrees Celsius and outlet side is 2.9 degrees Celsius. Now, we need to find out the LMTD for, or we need to find out the heat area. We can find out the area from Q is equal to UA delta T LM for cross flow heat exchanger or multipass heat exchanger. Cross flow or multipass heat exchanger. As we know, the delta T LM for multipass or cross flow heat exchanger, that will be equal to correction factor into LMTD of counterflow heat exchanger. Hence, first we need to find out the LMTD for counterflow heat exchanger. Okay. Now we need to find out the LMTD for counterflow heat exchanger. From the data book and by simply putting all this equation, we will get, please do it. Okay, try to do and check the values. LMTD for the counterflow heat exchanger is 10.92 degrees Celsius. Now we need to find out the value F for the correction factor. The correction factor F, we will get it from the graph which is plotted in the page number 159 in our HMT data book. Okay, here the P value and R value is calculated as 0.209 and 2.85. Okay, that means 0.209 and 2.875. From the HMT data book, the P value is 0.209, 0.2. Okay, so approximately we are taking it as 0.2. And the R value is 2.875. 2.875 means approximately equal to 3. Here, somewhere here. Okay. 2.875. Yes, approximately here will be there. And finally, we will get the graph will be somewhere here. It is actually points in our text, it is given it as 0.97. Okay, here the complete graph is not given. Here complete graph is not given. Just try to do and practice the problem like so. Here the answer is 0.97. Hence, our correction factor is 0.97. Take it as 97 or approximately equal to 0.99. Hence, the correction factor LMTD for the correction factor is F times the LMTD for the counterflow heat exchanger. That means 0.97 into the LMTD for the counterflow heat exchanger is 10.92. Our area is 0.672. Okay. Then, please do this with the help of these same input data. Please try to do the problems for the two shell passes and four tube passes. And there the area is 0.65. That means so for the tube shell passes and four tube passes, the area is decreasing. That means within the less space, we can able to make the more heat transfer effectively. Now, similarly, using the same data, please do it for the counterflow heat exchanger as well as for the both mixed data type and for the unmixed data type. Okay, please do it. It is very important. Now, we are going to see about the another problem, which is very important. Now, we are going to discuss it in the next lecture.